Hey guys, what's up? So a few weeks ago, I showed you how I fold an origami fish in just 10 seconds. Or 2 seconds if you speed it up. I'm going to show that to you again in slow motion at the end of this video. But now I'm going to show you what this model evolved into. It is, a fish. But a more complex fish. And not just any fish. This is a whole school of fish. And school's in session. I know that you want to fold this. So grab a sheet and let's get cracking. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a 10-inch square of kami, but you can really fold it from a 6-inch square. All right, so white side up, we're going to fold diagonally in half. So let's take this corner and fold it to here, but don't fold it all the way. Leave about a half a millimeter. So you have a tiny little white stripe here and here. You can't really see it, but just trust me. Okay, so now fold in half in this direction. And unfold. And now we're going to fold this edge up 1/3. So you want to fold it up so it's like this, so that this length is equal to this length. So just estimate. It doesn't have to be perfect, but just do your best. Okay, and now unfold, and let's fold this edge to the crease. And now let's fold this edge up. Okay, and let's rotate. And now we're going to fold this flat so that this point touches the midpoint of this edge. So where this crease hits this edge, we're going to fold this point right to that point, right there. And crease. Okay, now let's turn over. And now we're going to do the same thing. We're going to fold this point to right here. Okay, and now we're just going to switch these flaps like that so that one's on top. And now let's fold one corner up like this. How far? Well, this is going to be the size of the eye, so do it to eye. Okay, so now we're going to take this flap and we're going to fold it up. And we're folding this edge onto itself, and we're folding it how far? We're folding it so that this edge touches this point. So line it up like this, and you want to make sure that this edge lines up, and when it lines up, make the fold. Now let's rotate, and let's fold this flap up, and now you can just place the eye wherever you want, so it's going to be like about like this. Okay. And now stick this flap inside here. Now let's add a fin right here. So let's fold this flap from here and just sort of try to make it parallel with this edge. So about like that. And now fold it back out. We're going to make a little pleat right here. So we need to make a valley fold. And the valley fold is going to touch this point. So it converges right to here. And it goes back. And the smaller you can make it, the better. Because that way it'll be a larger fin. So that's what it looks like. And now let's do the same thing on the top. So for the top, let's fold it back. Let's first make our mountain fold about from this point to here. That's fine, or maybe a little bit less if you want it to have a rounded back. And now there's a little trick. What you can do is we're going to adjust this mountain fold and push it back a little bit more. So instead of right here, you just want to reach in and make it about there, a couple millimeters over like that. Okay, so now that'll cause this to stick up. And now, oh, by the way, the back looks like that. And now you can flatten it. All you do is put a little valley fold right in here as you flatten it. So it's just like that. And that way we have an extra large fin because we don't have any pleat on this side. Just like that. All right, and now let's do the tail. So let's fold this flap in like this, right, on this edge. And fold it back to taste. Just, you know, shorten it, maybe change the angle. So instead of it coming out like that, you want to push it back like this, so about like that. And now with this flap, fold it, well, let's turn it over. So it looks something like this. Let's fold this flap over this flap, like this. This is also to eye, it doesn't really matter. But let's turn it back over. Now we're going to fold the tail out, and we want to try to match this flap to this flap. So just make sure that it's about the same length. And you can sort of push it around to make sure that it looks good. And there's your fish. All right, so there's the fish. And now, how do you string it up if you want a school of fish? I recommend using thread, but I'm gonna show you how to do it with this cord just so that you are sure to see it. So what you do is you just unfold this flap, and you're going to take this flap and unfold it, and you stick your thread or string or cord right here, and you close it back up and put it back like it was. And now you close this over and stick it back like that. And here you have the fish and it hangs like this. All right, so here's the school of fish. And I like how you can swing the fish around and they always end up facing the right way. And you can even hold it like this and they'll go around in circles. But then when you bring it back, the fish come back into the right position. And you can shake the string to make them swim. All right, well, have fun with your school of fish and let me know what you think. See you later. Here's how to fold an origami fish in just 10 seconds. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ta-da! Nailed it! Yeah.